Hi, and congratulations on receiving your scholarships. This tutorial is to talk about how you're going to write your thank you letters, how you're going to save those thank you letters, and some kind of important things dealing with those templates. So, first and foremost, you have received this email from Stella Clark telling you about the scholarship or scholarships that you have received. This email has some really important information in it. It is going to tell you how many thank you letters you have to write for this particular scholarship. It's going to tell you when those thank you letters are due. It will have an attachment for a PowerPoint template that you're going to fill out for your thank you letter for this scholarship. When you fill this out, do not mess with the formatting. Keep it exactly the way it is. Save it as a PowerPoint. Just do all of the things that this video says. Don't mess around with things because printing these for the donors is a big deal. Some of the donors have like full notebooks of their printed thank you letters from all of the students that they have given their scholarship to over the years. And they just really enjoy that. They want to know how you're doing. If you receive the same scholarship multiple years in a row, they want a new letter from you every year because they love hearing how you're doing, which is also why if you receive a scholarship multiple years in a row, you're going to get a different template every year. So make sure you use the current template and follow these instructions. You'll see this is how we're going to save the letters. That's going to be important. We'll come back around to that when we get finished using the template. We are also going to talk about how that PowerPoint works. Again, guys, do not mess with it. Save it as a PowerPoint. Send it back to Stella Clark as a PowerPoint. Just leave it exactly the way it is. We also have this video link that you're already watching. And then you're going to see down here the name of your scholarship. Again, that's going to be important because you'll type it in your letter. Remember, if you get multiple different scholarships, the letters need to have the correct scholarship name in them, so pay attention to that. And finally, and this is also important, you're going to see how many thank you letters you need to write for this scholarship and who those thank you letters are to. So this particular scholarship, you're going to write one letter to Mr. and Mrs. Daniel, and then you're also going to write one letter to Dr. Oliver. A couple of important things on that. They're not all like this. Sometimes you're going to have to write multiple letters and it'll say to Mrs., I don't know, Jane Doe and to Mr. John Doe. If that's in one line, the way our Mr. and Mrs. Daniel are here, that means those guys are married and you're sending one letter to these two people. If they're in separate lines, so say it says letter one, Mr. John Doe, and then letter two, Mrs. Jane Doe, they are not married. Sometimes you have like a mother and son situation on the scholarships. Sometimes you have a sibling situation on the scholarships. So don't just assume that they're all going to the same person. If it says multiple letters, send back multiple letters. From there, you should also notice to help you out that there are multiple templates attached. So if you have to write two letters, there should be two PowerPoints attached for you. If you have to write four letters, there should be four. Don't save them all together. Make sure you save them separately. And like I said, we'll come back and talk about saving in a few minutes. So I've already got the PowerPoint open. It looks like that. This is the one for the year that we're working on. And what we're going to do, first of all, is we're going to add a professional headshot. Your professional headshot should be a nice photo of you that you wouldn't mind a future employer seeing. If you don't have a photo like that, grab a friend, grab your phone, put on a nice shirt, go take a nice professional headshot, and plop that photo in here. To do that, you're just going to click on this little photo icon. I have an example photo here. We're going to drop that in, and we've got that put together. We are then going to work through the rest of this stuff. So we're going to go down here. We're going to add our name. I think my name was Jane Jones. We are going to type in our hometown. I think Jane is going to be from Seattle, Washington. Make sure that when you type that in, you type out the full state. We want to make sure if you are doing a country that's something other than the US, type that out as well. And then we're going to jump down to our scholarship. So if I come back over here, I received the College of Engineering Biological Scholarship. So we'll type that in. So we put that here. We are going to put in our major, which I'm going to say is biological engineering. Then we are going to fill in some interests and hobbies. Guys, these don't have to be complete sentences. They are bullet points for a reason. So, hiking, hanging out with my dogs. Well, let's try and type reading correctly. And let's just say enjoying the fun activities Fayetteville has to offer. Again, like I said before, your donors love hearing about what you're doing. So fill that out. If you want to elaborate, you can put more stuff about your hobbies and extracurricular activities down here later. Oh, you know what? Let's also remember, don't forget that you can do some tutoring. Or you can add some other academic things that you're involved in. I can't think of a club offhand, but don't forget about those for your activities. And we've got our main stuff filled out here. Notice we didn't change anything. We kept all of the formatting exactly the way it was when it was sent to us. We are then going to jump down here to the body of the letter. So you can actually type your letter here if you want to. We can say, Dear Mr. and Mrs. Daniel, and we can just, oops, that's not how you spell Daniel. We can just continue right on along our way. Or what I've actually done here is I have pre-typed my letter. I have it all over here. I'm going to copy and paste that in. If that's easier for you, cool. If it's not, that's also not a big deal. Notice though, guys, I am going to copy and paste this. I am not going to take a photo of it. I'm going to just go ahead and put it in as text. I am going to use the paintbrush feature to make sure it's in the correct formatting because that did not drop in here the way I wanted it to. So, whew, I got lucky. Sorry if my mouse is being messy. Notice that that filled the first page. I'm going to go ahead and leave it exactly the way it is. I'm not going to mess with the formatting at all. I'm going to then jump over to the second page and come back and get the rest of my text. And this time I'm going to try to work smarter, not harder, and see if I can get it to paste with my formatting. Oh, it doesn't want to, does it? All right, we'll paste that and then we'll just jump back over here and use our paintbrush tool again. Remember, you want your formatting to be exactly the same. So make sure you go ahead and use that font that Stella has provided for you in this template. We've got that all together. That is what we want it to look like. Notice that nothing got changed around. All of my stuff is exactly where it was. You can type the full second page if you want to. Make sure that there are at least three paragraphs in your letter. Thank your donors for the scholarship. Let them know what you're doing. You know, if you're getting the scholarship again, update them on how your education's going, what's going on a little bit with you. They do really love to hear about that. And then we are going to save this. I've been messing around with this template, so I'm going to actually go to save as again, which is probably what you want to do as well. When we save this, we want to save it your last name, your first name, and then you want to put in the names or just name of the people that this letter is to. So in this case, I am Jones, comma Jane, and this letter is to Mr. and Mrs. Daniel. I'm going to save it exactly like that. So we're going to go ahead and save that, and it's exactly the way we want it. That's how we're going to email it back to Stella Clark. From there, we are going to go open the second attachment. So let me actually jump back over here and download my template for letter two. Fingers crossed that this one does everything I want it to. And we will fill it out the same way. I know this is kind of annoying, but we'll go through. We will grab our photo. We will put our major in again. And I can actually copy and paste this from the first one. That would be so much easier. Let me grab my hobbies. So we'll throw those in there. Let's see. I am Jane Jones. My hometown was Seattle, Washington. And I don't want to type that scholarship name again, so I'm just going to jump over here and copy and paste. This letter is my second letter. If you look in my email, you will see that my second letter needs to go to Dr. Oliver. So I'm going to come back over here. I'm going to say, Dear Dr. Oliver. And then I'm just going to copy and paste out of my original letter. Whoops, let's not do anything with that. Control Z is around for a reason, right? So we'll copy and paste from that first page. Fortunately, I will not have to reformat this time, so that's really nice. We will copy and paste from the second page. And the big thing on this one is showing you guys how to save. So that's my letter. This is template two. And I'm going to go ahead and save as. Again, it's going to be Jones, Jane, so your first name, sorry, your last name, your first name, and then the person that you wrote this letter to. So this is Dr. Oliver, if I can spell his name correctly, and we'll go ahead and save that. That's everything as far as filling out your letter, as far as saving your letters. It's really important that you do not edit this template at all. Just type the stuff in that you need to type in. Don't move the picture around. Don't change the formatting at all. Save it as a PowerPoint. When these go to be printed, PowerPoint is the way they have to print them. So don't save it as a Google Doc. Don't save it as a PDF. Literally leave it as a PowerPoint and follow those steps for saving. A couple of other important things for your letter. Don't put a date on it. Some ideas for your letter outline. Remember, change the name for every letter. If you got different scholarships, you can still use the same letter, but you need to make sure you change the scholarship name on scholarship received. And then if you said that scholarship name anywhere in your letter, obviously change that as well. Here, some helpful things for writing. Use that first paragraph, introduce yourself, thank the donor for their generosity, for their support. I received some scholarships like this in college. It was a big deal. And then we are going to go to the second paragraph, talk about our personal history, where we grew up, why we want to study engineering, why you came to the U of A, all those things about, what makes you want to be doing what you're doing. Use that third paragraph to talk about your academic background, some aspirations, other universities you've attended, your, research, any accomplishments, that kind of thing. And for your final paragraph, express your appreciation for the funding, talk about why it's meaningful to you. Again, guys, these donors love to receive these letters. They deeply, deeply care about this money impacting your education. So shoot them a good line of thank you. If you're receiving a scholarship for multiple times, they're going to be so excited to hear about what you're doing this year as opposed to last year. And most importantly, when you save these things, follow exactly what the email from Stella says about saving them. And then we're just going to reattach them, send them back to her, and get those in as soon as possible. The sooner you get them in, the sooner they can start working on editing and things like that. Don't wait till the last minute. And if you have any questions, feel free to reach out and ask what's going on. Make sure you know how to do everything. Hopefully, this video is helpful. And again, congratulations on your scholarship.